finds a link between a common childhood virus and a higher risk of developing autoimmune diseases. Here to talk about that is Dr. Kristin Moffitt, an infectious disease specialist at Boston Children's Hospital. Great to see you as always,
Dr. Hey, Dr. Moffitt, it's great to see you. So let's talk about the virus. First of all, let's start, what is it called?
Sure, yeah, it's rotavirus.
Rotavirus
is a very common cause of a gastrointestinal infection.
And how does it spread?
Yeah, so rotavirus as a gastrointestinal infection that usually causes symptoms of diarrhea and vomiting and fever is actually shed through the stool of somebody who's having a rotavirus infection. And other people end up getting rotavirus if they go ahead and get it into their mouths, either via unwashed hands or by touching or eating something that's been contaminated with the virus.
Doctor, because you're a doctor, we're not. Most patients recover quickly from a rotavirus infection, but there are kids out there who develop more severe symptoms. They have to go to the hospital. What did this study find?
Yeah, so this was an interesting study. It was a very large study of almost 2 million children that were born in Korea between the years of 2002 and 2005. And they used insurance data to look at the number of children who had to be hospitalized for a rotavirus infection in very young childhood. And what they found in following up insurance diagnosis data for about 12 years was that compared to young children who had not needed to be hospitalized for rotavirus, those who did had about a 1.5 times higher likelihood of being diagnosed with an autoimmune disease such as lupus or an autoimmune type of arthritis. And that was, again, compared to those who'd not needed to be hospitalized for rotavirus. So this is a potential association. It doesn't suggest that rotavirus infection causes autoimmune disease. Mm-hmm. But it does suggest that those children who needed hospitalization for rotavirus when they were young were at increased risk of autoimmune disease.
Dr. Moffitt, there are two vaccines available in the United States, right, to protect infants from rotavirus?
Correct.
So how well do they work?
Yeah, the good news is they work very well. There are two, exactly as you say, both of them are given orally, and they start at the 2 month of age time point during routine pediatric immunizations. And they've been used routinely in the US as part of the pediatric immunization schedule since about 2006. So that might follow then that if you performed the same study here in the United States, and there were any association between rotavirus hospitalization and autoimmune disease, it would be pretty significantly decreased because those vaccines are about 90% effective at preventing severe rotavirus disease that leads to hospitalization, and they're about 70% effective at preventing rotavirus infection in young children at all. Mm-hmm. So another potential benefit of vaccination.
All right, Dr. Moffitt, thank you so much. We always appreciate it.
Yeah, sure. Good.